Hey, looks like you've got a bit of rivalry going on out there. This is good. Gets people talking about you. Just make sure you outperform them, okay?
Hi, how are you? I'm just passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
Welcome to Melbourne, where qualifying for the Australian Grand Prix should be getting underway shortly. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
No matter how good a driver is at managing their throttle application to limit rear slip, they can't always overcome a car that's inherently bad at looking after its rear tyres. Here we have a lot of low-speed corner exits, which means a whole load of energy, heat and tyre wear.
Grid is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Hamilton, Rosberg, and Max Verstappen. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
They say that even a second is an eternity in Formula One, so going four winter months with no racing at all has seemed a very long time indeed. We're back though in Melbourne, home of the Australian Grand Prix since 1996. We go racing today then in the state of Victoria, where the drivers have 16 corners and 3.3 miles to navigate at an average lap speed of around 120 miles an hour. The close proximity of the barriers makes accidents inevitable, and recent history shows us that a safety car is not at all out of the question. I, for one, can't wait to get started, and there's another very excited little chap here beside me as well. It's our very own Anthony Davidson. Great to see you again today.
Thanks for that, Crofty, and I'm really anxious to get underway here. We've got all the makings of a great race today. world champions in competitive cars, lots of drivers on form, and I suspect a few strategists on the pit wall looking to try something a bit different and maybe jump their cars up the order.
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long, so the pack will be bunched up. Take care.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position with Nico Rosberg alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Ricciardo, Kevin Magnussen, and Vettel, Bottas, and Renault, Raikkonen, and Sergio Perez, Kvyat, Grosjean, Nico Hülkenberg, and Harry Anto, Massa, Sainz, Fernando Alonso, and Esteban Gutierrez, Button, and Wehrlein, Marcus Ericsson, and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track. great win then for the Mercedes team today. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Lewis Hamilton takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after an excellent result. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Well, my driver of the day was Nico Hülkenberg. He did a cracking job moving through the field and just highlighting why he's so highly rated in the paddock.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.